will stay at pick 37 and go to the interior of the offensive line, selecting Landon Dickerson out of Alabama. Thanks for joining us here on Eagles Draft Central, presented by Dietz and Watson. And Ross, I'm just going to come right to you. Ross pretty much all but squealed when he found out that the Eagles were taking his favorite player in this draft. What do you love about this pick, Ross?
Well, listen, if you watched the pre-draft show, like you should have, I said Landon Dickerson was my single favorite player in this draft. I love everything about this dude. He's hilarious. He's physical. He can play every position. He tries to finish and put people down. This is a guy that suited up and got in the national championship game with a torn ACL because it meant that much to him and it meant that much to his teammates that they put him in for the kneel down at the end of this game. I have yet to hear anyone related to Alabama or otherwise say a bad thing about this kid. Look, the only issue is the injury history. But if he didn't have that, if he had the injury history, he would have gone top 20. That's the value they're getting here.
You're getting a player that has started games at every single position along the offensive line. That versatility, you know, is so, so important. And I think when you talk about a guy like Landon Dickerson, and when you speak with offensive line experts in the media, in the business, inside the industry, everybody swears by Landon Dickerson, his film, his toughness, his technique, his athleticism, his ability to get up and make plays at every single level. And you watch that run game, Najee Harris, and what they were able to do, he is just destroying people on a weekly basis. It's the Devontae Smith discussion where it's like, just watch him against the SEC every single week, and he's just dominating every single defensive lineman that lined up across from him. He is so much fun to watch. The Eagles got a really good player here. Obviously, the medical history is a little bit worrisome, but when you talk about the talent and the person, there's nothing to complain about.
Well, and if you're concerned about some of those injuries, you can just hop on social media right now, and there's a video of Landon Dickerson from the end of March doing cartwheels behind a Mac Jones interview, which is just awesome. He looks fine and also hilarious, to your point, Ross. The other thing I love about this pick, you talk about an SEC offensive lineman, Alabama having a history of putting star offensive linemen in the league, going against top competition in the SEC. And the other thing that I love is when you want to set up your young quarterback for success, you give him a strong offensive line and you give him some weapons. Two guys from Alabama now for this young quarterback for the Eagles, guys he already is familiar with, Ron.
Well, and you guys know, and Fran, I've talked about it for years, I love Jason Kelce. I love Brandon Brooks, two of my favorite players in the league. They're not getting any younger. They're not. And Brandon Brooks, coming off of a significant injury history, the Eagles are always going to make sure that they have depth and talent along the offensive line. Always. It is an organizational priority. It always will be. It's a big reason why they have success when they do. It's a big reason why they won the Super Bowl. It's a big reason in 2019 they went to the playoffs, even though the skill guys were all a bunch of practice squad guys. They had the best O-line in the NFL in 2019. They are always going to make sure that they have a top 10 offensive line. You have to replenish the rank. If you're going to do that, you have to take second-round picks like Landon Dickerson.
And, two, when you talk about his versatility, you mentioned the older guys that are on the team right now that are going to be starters for this roster. When you look at Landon Dickerson, if there is an injury up front, he could fill in any of those spots. He's already proven that he can do that in the college level. That's why that versatility is so, so important for those rookies when they're coming into the league.
Well, and look, if we look at the history here in Philadelphia, versatility on the offensive line is key because you will be called upon to play multiple positions. All right, and with that, we are now going to the Eagles insider, Dave Spadaro, to get his take on this pick. Landon Dickerson, interior offensive lineman from Alabama. Two Alabama picks in the first two picks for the Eagles. Dave, what has been kind of the reaction from what you've observed from the staff?
Yeah, I mean, the Eagles obviously wanted this guy very badly, a player that not a whole lot of people in the media, the fans talking about, but very highly rated among the scouts and around the league. A tremendous football player, but the injury history is a factor. Torn ACL in December, how quickly can he come back and play? This is a long-term projection. Let's take a look at our chart here and the depth chart of offensive line. You look at the center position, how many more years is Jason Kelce going to play? And who's your replacement? Now, the thinking generally had been that Isaac Seumalo could be somebody to slide over into the center spot. Absolutely a possibility. Also, as Ross pointed out, with the injuries that Brandon Brooks has suffered, with the advanced age of this offensive line, Eagles certainly are replenishing, not just for 2021, but for the future. This is not just a move for 2021. So if you're thinking, oh my gosh, I'm not sure that this player is going to be able to contribute in 2021, you might be right. But it's a long-term play for an extremely talented player who, had he been healthy, would have been gone early in day one.
Dave, you and I talked last night about DeVonta Smith and that toughness factor, that competitiveness factor. And I think when you talk about Landon Dickerson, the same kind of words, those same buzzwords pop up in scouting reports, whoever you talk to. How big of a factor is that for this Eagles front office and this coaching staff as they're continuing to collect talent here this weekend?
Yeah, Fran, no doubt that Nick Sirianni wants toughness. He also wants athleticism, and Landon has that athleticism. He has the versatility. Again, big-time player at a big-time program who's won national championships and who can play anywhere along the offensive line at 6 feet, 6 inches tall. So intriguing pick. I'm sure that fans are kind of sitting there going, whoa, there were some defensive players on the board. Where's the help for the defense? The Eagles need help at all three levels on defense. Eagles still have 8 selections remaining. They will get to the defense here, but they just are trusting their board right now. This is a player that I would guarantee you they had a grade much higher than early second round. They have a player here who they think can come in here and be a difference maker. Now, the big question here, keep your fingers crossed, is the health factor. And I'm sure we'll hear from Nick and Howie and Andy Weidel after the draft explaining why they think they can keep him healthy.
Dave, we all know that Jeff Stoutland used to be the offensive line coach at Alabama with Nick Saban. So for Jeff Stoutland to sign off on this and say, this is the guy I want, you have to think that Nick Saban spoke glowingly to his former offensive line coach. How important are those relationships?
Yeah, very important, Ross. And just understand this. This draft pick is not being made if Jeff Stoutland does not sign off on it. So, I mean, Stout is one of the best in the business, in the history of the business, and has a very close relationship, obviously, at Alabama, knows what he's looking for. The Eagles have done their work on the medical side of it. I don't know where he stands for 2021, but I do know this. The Eagles expect this young man to be part of the offensive line for many, many years. And it's really interesting because we kind of thought that last year, with all of the injuries up front, that getting players like Jack Driscoll and Herbig and Pryor and Sua, all of the Opetta, all of these reps, that it would really bolster the depth. And it did. But it just goes to show that deep down, the core values of the Philadelphia Eagles, you build from the interior out. And so that's why this pick makes so much sense. Again, not a play necessarily for 2021, we'll see, but a long-term play with an extremely talented young man.
Well, Dave, of course, the staff here has said that this is going to be Eagles fans need to have some patience with the rebuild, so great point there.
Yeah, but it's all about a vision. And remember what Howie Roseman said Wednesday when we spoke to him. Every pick has a plan. Every pick has a vision. And we'll hear him explain the pick and the vision behind it.
Awesome. Great stuff. As always, Dave, I'm sure we'll catch up with you a little bit later in the evening. Thanks so much for joining us.
All right. Round number 3. Get here in a hurry.
Ooh, yes. Very exciting. I love the energy around this and just a little bit of a surprise, maybe not. I want to talk to you about this a little bit more, Ross. When you look at the Eagles offensive line that they have, Dickerson's potential, is the injury concern the only thing holding him back from being a day one starter?
Correct. Well, and the Eagles have good guys in front of them right now. Yeah, but look, it's really simple. If he gets injured again and isn't able to really play, it's a bad pick. If he doesn't, it's a slam dunk, and that's a risk that the Eagles are willing to take on. Remember after the season when the owner, Jeffrey Lurie, talked about this being a transition year? They have a lot of picks already, likely 3 first-round picks in 2022, okay? That's what this is about. He will help. The odds are he will help and contribute in 2021 because of injuries. But I think he's starting somewhere in 2022, Fran, one way or the other.
Yeah, and this is a player you talked about, the relationship factor with Jeff Stoutland and Nick Saban. And we've talked about how unique this NFL draft process has been. Those relationships are so important this year, more so than any other, because you didn't have the face-to-face time with these players that you normally would have leading up to a draft. Those top 30 visits, the private workouts, the on-campus visits during the fall, they didn't exist. So having those pre-existing relationships, whether they're coaches on the coaching coaching staff, scouts, general managers, whatever it is, you're going to lean on them more often this year than you would even normally.
That's a great point. And look, you can already start kind of drawing those connections with what we've seen so far. Two guys from Alabama, familiarity between a quarterback and a receiver, familiarity between a lineman and a coach. So a lot to be excited about here in Philadelphia. Of course, we will be right back here live immediately after the next pick. Right now, we're looking at pick number 70 in the next round, in the third round. But my guess is that that may move and shift. So be sure to keep an eye on everything. We'll be right back here as soon as the pick is made to break it all down for you on Eagles Draft Central.